Hello friends, today I want to solve the most complicated tank problem, which we have two openings at different level. D1 equal to 0.1 meter, 1.5 meter below the top of the tank, and D2 equal to 0.08 meter at the bottom of the tank. Let us solve this problem. Okay, height of the tank is 3 meter and H is 1.5 meter below the top of the tank. Also, diameter of the tank equal to 2 meter and D1 equal to 0.1 meter, D2 equal to 0.08 meter. We use this formula for finding velocity. Velocity equal to square root 2 multiply acceleration g multiply head. And A1 is constant, so we can find A1. A1 equal to 0.25 pi, diameter 1 which is equal to 0.1 square, so the area 1 equal to 0.00785 meter square. Also, we can find area 2. Area 2 equal to 0.25 pi, 0.08 square. So, area 2 equal to 0.05 meter square. And also, find the area of tank. Area of tank equal to 0.25 pi, multiply diameter of the tank, which is 2, square. So, area of tank equal to 3.1459 meter square. Okay. Next, we have to find the velocity 1. Velocity 1 equal to 2 multiply 9.81 multiply 1.5, because at first head is 1.5 meter above the opening. So velocity 1 equal to 5.42 meter per second. Then find the discharge for discharge 1. Q1 equal to P1 multiply D1. So 0.00785 multiply velocity. We get the discharge, which is equal to 0.042547 meter cubic per second. That is the discharge 1. Also, for the second opening, we can find velocity and discharge. Velocity equal to square root 2 multiply 9.81 multiply 3, because head is 3 at first time. So velocity 2 equal to 7.67 meter per second, and Q2 equal to A2 multiply B2, that's A2 multiply B2 equal to 0.0387 meter cube per second. That is discharge for the second opening. So both opening has influence on emptying the tank. So we have to sum up this to discharge. Q total equal to Q1 plus Q2. So it equals 0.042547 plus 0.0386. Q total equal to 0.0811 meter cubic per second. That is Q total. By dividing area of tank, we can find the rate of decreasing water in the tank. So Q total divided by A tank equal to dHdt. dHdt is the rate of decreasing water in the tank. Okay. dHdt equal to Q total divided by area, so the rate of decreasing in the tank is 0.0258 meter per second. If we assume dt equal to 1 second, so we can find the decreasing of water in the tank. So dh equal to 0.0258 meter per second multiply 1 second, so dh equal to 0.0258. That's at the first second. At the first second, the water decreased in the tank this much. So it's a complicated procedure. So we use Microsoft Excel to find the time required for emptying the tank. Okay. Here we have the data. Tank diameter 2 meter and tank height 3 meter. H equals 1.5, D1 0.1, D2 0.08 meter, gravity 9.81 meters per second square. So let's calculate the area of tank. Area of tank equal to 0.25 multiply pi. Okay, multiply diameter of tank, which is 2 square. That's area of tank. And area 1 equal to, if we just drag it equal to 0.25 pi multiply D1. D1 equal to C5. Just change C3 to C5. Okay, that's area 1. Drag this one. It will be area 2. And DT, we can choose as we like. I choose 1 at first. Till delta T smaller, we get more accurate result. Okay, time. Here at first, delta T equal to 0. Oh no, time equal to 0. So the second one equal to 1. It is constant this one. Okay. And this cell equal to this plus this one. Constant C13. Okay, if we drag, it should increase one by one. Okay, it is good. Let's find head. Head at first equal to 3. When time 0, head is 3 because no water comes out from the tank. Okay. We see that water comes out till water goes down by 1.5 meter. But if head smaller than 1.5, so no more water comes out from the opening one. Let us provide a function, a condition here. So if head greater than 1.5, so V1 equal to square root 2 multiply 9.81 multiply this minus 1.5. Otherwise, or if head greater is smaller than 1.5, it should be 0. Okay, that is V1. V1 equal to 5.4249, and V2 equal to square root, or we can also use the condition. F changes to F2. If F2 greater than 0, velocity to equal to square root 29.81 multiply F2, otherwise equal to 0. Okay, that is velocity 2. So Q1 equal to V1 multiply A1. Make A1 constant. Okay, that is Q1. And Q2 equal to V2 multiply A2. Make A2 constant. That is, there is a wrong, what's wrong? H2, not as H2, multiply A2, a point, let us examine. Yes, Q2 0.386, it's right. Okay, and Q total equal to Q total equal to Q1 plus Q2, and dHdt decreasing rate equal to Q total divided by area tank. Make area tank constant. Okay. And dH equal to rate of decreasing water level in the tank multiply delta T. Make delta T constant. Okay. At first, second water decreased by 0.20258. Okay. This time head equal to this one minus this. Okay. So this time head equal to 2.97. And just drag this. Okay. You see, at the second time velocity is smaller, because when head decreases, velocity decreases. Here should be also here. It means that our calculation is right. Okay. Yes. It is track. Okay. Okay, we see that the result is, the time is, the required time is 422 seconds. We need 422 seconds for emptying the tank. Let us find, okay, 1 minute. You see, when the tank, the head of the tank will be 1.49, directly velocity 1 equal to 0. And Q2 equal to 0, because no more water comes out. Okay. That is the calculation for the tank which we have to open it. If we change delta T, for example, for 2, you see how the result will change. At first 422, but here is 418. As I told, as we reduce the delta T, the result will be more accurate. Okay. Also, you can make a graph between head and velocity. I hope it be helpful. Have a nice time.